Melvin Horace Purvis, Jr. was an American law enforcement official and Federal Bureau of Investigation agent. He was given the nickname Little Mel because of his short stature. He is noted for leading the manhunts that tracked such outlaws as Babyface Nelson, Pretty Boy Floyd, and John Dillinger. Early life: Purvis was born in Timmonsville, South Carolina, to Melvin Horace Purvis, Sr., a pig farmer, and Janie Elizabeth as the fifth of 12 siblings. Career: Purvis was a well-educated man, and known to be a crackshot. He received his law degree from the University of South Carolina and had a brief career as a lawyer. Purvis was a member of the Kappa Alpha Order while attending South Carolina. He joined the FBI in 1927 and headed the Division of Investigation offices in Birmingham, Oklahoma City, and Cincinnati. In 1932, he was placed in charge of the Chicago office by Bureau of Investigation Director J. Edgar Hoover. Purvis captured more public enemies than any other agent in FBI history, a record that still stands. Purvis led the manhunts that tracked outlaws Babyface Nelson and Pretty Boy Floyd, and most famously John Dillinger, which ended in Chicago on July 22, 1934. However, after Purvis became a media figure for this feat, Hoover claimed that Purvis had been demoted and Agent Samuel P. Cowley had been put in charge of the Dillinger case. Cowley was later shot by Babyface Nelson, and Purvis visited him in the hospital shortly before he died. Purvis was praised for his actions. He reportedly incurred the wrath of Hoover, who had previously supported him, as Purvis sought and achieved publicity for his own role, overshadowing Hoover and the rest of the FBI. In a 2005 book co-authored by Purvis' son Austin, Hoover is portrayed as jealous of the attention given to Purvis after Dillinger was killed. At least one of Purvis' official accounts of his exploits was later called into question. Purvis' story of the death of Pretty Boy Floyd indicated that Purvis and his agents had killed him with no assistance from local law enforcement. This was later disputed by Chester Smith, an officer with the East Liverpool, Ohio police. Officer Smith said that Purvis and his agents never fired until after Purvis had attempted to question Floyd. After Floyd responded with curses, Purvis ordered Agent Herman Ed Hollis to shoot Floyd, who was lying wounded on the ground. This claim was discounted later by retired FBI agent Winfred E. Hopton, who wrote in a 1976 letter to Time that local law enforcement, including Captain Smith, weren't even present until after Floyd had died. Of course, this version conflicts with the one from local authorities, which has Smith initially wounding Floyd. Neither claim has been clearly proven. Purvis resigned from the FBI in 1935 and afterward practiced law. In 1937, he became engaged to actress Janice Gerard, but they never married. He later married Marie Roseanne Wilcox, and they had three sons. In 1936, Purvis published a memoir of his years as an investigator with the Bureau, entitled American Agent. Purvis served in the United States Army as an intelligence officer during World War II, reaching the rank of colonel. He assisted with compiling evidence against Nazi leaders in the Nuremberg trials. Death: on February 29, 1960, while at his home in Florence, Purvis died from a gunshot wound to the head fired from the pistol given to him by fellow agents when he resigned from the FBI. The FBI investigated his death and declared it a suicide, although the official coroner's report did not label the cause of death as such. A later investigation suggested that Purvis may have shot himself accidentally while trying to extract a tracer bullet jammed in the pistol. He was 56 years old. Other media: in documentaries, Purvis was portrayed by Dale Robertson in GMAN, The Rise and Fall of Melvin Purvis, from SCETV's Carolina Stories documentary series. Purvis was portrayed by Scott Brooks in the History Channel documentary on infamous gangsters, Crime Wave, 18 Months of Mayhem. In films and TV movies, Melvin Purvis, G-Man is a 1974 American TV movie about Melvin Purvis, starring Dale Robertson. Purvis was portrayed by Ben Johnson in the film Dillinger. He was played by Jeffrey Binney, opposite Martin Sheen, in the title role of the TV movie The Story of Pretty Boy Floyd. Purvis was portrayed again by Dale Robertson in the TV movie The Kansas City Massacre, a sequel to Melvin Purvis, G-Man. He was portrayed by Will Patton in the TV movie Dillinger. Purvis was originally portrayed by Chuck Wagner in the musical Dillinger, Public Enemy No. 1. Purvis is portrayed by Christian Bale in the film Public Enemies. In print, Purvis appears with Elliot Ness as an agent of the Federal Bureau of Ideology, who are in pursuit of labor activist Tom Joad, in Kim Newman's alternate history novel Back in the USSA. In 1937, Parker Brothers published a game called Melvin Purvis G-Men Detective Game. Purvis is the title character in Dennis Johnson's play, Purvis. References. Further reading, One Account of the Death of Pretty Boy Floyd, Potter, Claire. War on Crime, Bandits, G-Men, and the Politics of Mass Culture. Rutgers University Press. ISBN 0-8135-2487-3. Purvis, Alston. Trisanowski, Alex. The Vendetta, FBI Hero Melvin Purvis's War Against Crime and J. Edgar Hoover's War Against Him. Public Affairs. ISBN 1-58648-301-3. J. Edgar Hoover, The Man and the Secrets, by Kurt Gentry. Official and Confidential, The Secret Life of J. Edgar Hoover, by Anthony Summers, Putnam. External links, Melvin Purvis at Find a Grave.